racism and authoritarianism go hand in hand, and they have always gone hand in hand. My name's David Lin. I'm a former speechwriter for President Obama, and I'm the author of this new book, Democracy in One Book or Less: How It Works, Why It Doesn't, and Why Fixing It is Easier Than You Think. Systemic racism hasn't just influenced our democracy. Systemic racism is embedded within our political process itself. Let me give you just one example. In 2012, on average, black voters waited for 23 minutes to cast a vote. White voters waited for just 12 minutes. So think about this. Nearly 50 years after the Civil Rights Act and the Voting Rights Act, black voters were waiting twice as long to cast their ballot, to exercise their democratic rights, as white voters were. And this is not an example of the system being broken. It's an example of the system doing what it was constructed in order to do. In so many cases, it turns out that our democracy itself was designed to make racial justice harder to fight for. The Electoral College, the filibuster, in some states, even voter registration systems. These aren't democratic institutions. They're the things that are corrupting our democratic institutions. The Electoral College is a direct legacy of slavery. The filibuster in the Senate was segregationists' main tool for making sure that for a half a century, civil rights bills could not pass even though they had public support. Even something as simple and boring sounding as voter registration is in many cases directly tied to white supremacy. Here's the one that most shocked me when I learned about it. In Texas, until the 1960s, they did not have any statewide system of voter registration. No voter registration. What they did have was something called the poll tax. But they also had a law that they passed in the 1940s. It said, if for some reason we are forced to give up our poll tax, our number one voter suppression tool, we have another plan B just waiting in the wings. We're gonna put it in place, and it's called statewide voter registration. So today, Texas still has one of the lowest turnout rates in the nation, and one of the reasons for that is that the voter registration in the state was specifically set up as a backstop for Jim Crow. Here's another example. Laws disenfranchising people who either are or were in prison. When it suddenly became no longer legal for southern states to keep black people from voting, they came up with this kind of bank shot. First, they said, if you've ever committed a felony in our state, you can't vote for the rest of your life, even after you've served your time. And then after that, they vastly expanded the definition of a felony and used law enforcement to target specifically black and brown communities. And these kind of laws are still on the books. In 2016, they cost 6 million Americans their voting rights, disproportionately non-white Americans their voting rights. And this is not a mistake. These kind of disparities are in our system. They're in our political process by design. This is such an important moment in our history, when Americans are finally ready to reckon with our history in a way we have not been in the past. We don't want our democratic process to stand in the way. We need it to help us make change. But if we have a political process that stops us at every turn, we won't get the future that we are fighting for today. But here's the good news. We the people still have the tools we need to fight authoritarianism, restore our democracy, and remove some of that stain of racism and white supremacy from our country's political institutions. With just one law, we could pass automatic voter registration and re-enfranchise millions upon millions of Americans. We could get rid of the Electoral College. If senators hold up valuable civil rights legislation, we can end the Senate filibuster. None of these steps is going to solve every single problem overnight. Of course not. But they're all doable, and we should do them. So after 2.5 years spent researching the way American democracy really works, here's my prediction. I think that if we focus on fixing our country's foundations, not just on policies, but on repairing the machinery of government, on repairing our political process, we will have a real, true representative democracy within Mitch McConnell's lifetime. And I, for one, cannot wait to see the look on his face.